The final match then of the WTT Series 2023, and what a match in prospect. The top two in the world. The last two winners of this title. Fang Zhendong, the confirmed year-end world number one. The world champion in singles and doubles. Winner from 21 against his doubles partner, the defending champion. I mean, this has got so, so much going for it. Really, really hope you can enjoy this. Straight at it there, the defending champion taking the attack to Fang.
Surprised Fang that serve there. Managed to improvise, but then it was curtains. Can't really lob down Wang Chu Chin.
Just getting started. Just warming up. Plenty more to come from these two.
Light speed. I'm sure that has just set the tone. Fasten your seat belts, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh. Yeah, no holding back there. Why would there be with what's on the line?
One of the straightest arms in world table tennis when he revs up for that and can treat a decent push like it's beginner level. Wang Chu Chin goes into the body like a bullet of Fang Zhendong off the loose ball, suffocating at its best.
Interesting as well, actually, being around the two, watching, commentating the matches with you, Fraser, this week, and indeed as we've done through the season, because these two have just won titles for fun through the campaign. But how they've approached the week, something we've talked about here, but it's worth returning to, I think, about mindset, in different ways how they've carved their way through the draw. As we reflect, as we should do, on the week and the season as a whole.
Oh, well, I think with regards to these two players, they do have a slightly different personality. I mean, Wang Chu Chin, extremely fiery. I mean, look at his nickname, Lionheart. Fang Zhendong, for me, is more ice cool, where Wang Chu Chin brings that firepower aspect. You can see the differences in celebrations as a telling sign, for example. But at the end of the day, it's the man who can control their emotions more that will probably win this match, because they are so close in standard. That semi, for me, for Fang Zhendong against Lin Gaoyuan, was just amazing how relaxed he looked. However, when you look at Wang Chuqin's performance over the Europameister Dang Zhou, identically impressive. But there is something slightly different in personality in these two men.
Yeah, you talk about, I think what you're getting at, Fraser, is you talk about their wonderful, what they've got at their disposal at the table, their shots. I mean, there's nothing, we talk about that, we wax lyrical about that, we just marvel at it, at their quality. But it's those, you know, slightly less tangible factors that decide these occasions, and relaxation, feeling relaxed, is a big part of that. You know, that's not something, I say it's less tangible because, you know, it's not something they're giving away. I mean, they're the masters as well of playing that poker face, if you like, as well. You don't see it so easily there that they are inside, that maybe they're struggling a bit more, but it's there. They're human beings. I mean, I know that's tough to believe watching them, all of you watching it out here, that they are, but they are. And it's, as you say, it's who can be, feel the most relaxed inside, who's then able to bring their very, very best to the biggest occasion.
it's the player who can basically just treat it like, okay, I'm just going to play my shots here. I'm going to play my shot one by one. Play my shot. We pizzazz it up as mere table tennis mortals. These guys are basically untouchable for the rest of the pack, aka the world.
What a punchy finish there, a bit of over as well from Wang. Imparting so much pace into that off the table.
Wang's backhand is a little bit different from Fan's. Fan's are more of a coiled compact backhand. Wang uses a little bit more forearm before bending the wrist back and then coming onto contact with the closed racket angle. What it means is Wang's, for me, is actually especially deep on the table. Best thing you can do with your loops, the vast majority of the time, depending on where your opponent stood, is to try and get it as close to that back line as possible. Easier to come in over the ball with a counter if it's shallow.
It's not bad, is it? You really can take all this for granted. And you really shouldn't. You just make it look so easy. Game points here against the defending champion in favour of the former winner.
Spanks it. It's a common theme, but we're going to see these pros trying to get it into the middle. That one was spinny. Deep and into the middle, and you can see Fan was just called for space, not comfortable.
Well, you talked about Fraser, his unflappable nature. This is still very early in the final here, but Wang has, of course, come to play here. You talk about mindset. Fan has built his way through this draw, has raised his level round by round. Wang never felt that he was able really to do that with the draw that he had.
Yeah, it's the way he comes firing out of the blocks, and it's the minerals. Obviously, being the first ever Chinese male to win all four events available at an Asian Games, then coming into Lanzhou off the back of that, having to use an oxygen tank because he was struggling with the altitude, exhausted, and still won the title. Still came through the entire draw. I mean, this guy, if you literally type in unflappable on the internet, Wang Chuqin comes up. And that has to be in the mind of Fan, and it will be. He knows he has to win on this match. Win it, take it. You can't rely on Wang to have a bad day. It'll be over in the blink of an eye.
Yeah, of course, they both feel that way. Utter respect for the other and what they can do. But again, say here as they come to the first towel break of game two with Wang opening up this commanding lead, it seems. It's just been his draw, really, in the way he started. He referenced it. He said, you know, I just couldn't afford against Felix Lebrun. And I think it's helped him through the draw because he's just stayed in that headspace.
Yeah, yeah.
Had that rematch of last year's final with the improving again Tomokazu Harimoto. And then the way, as you said, that he took apart Dang Chou, who had his, in many ways, his career best week to that point.
Starting to wonder here if Fan Jendong's going to get a taste of what Ma Long's felt like in finals against Wang Chuqin this season.
Oh! That is utterly glorious. And he needed it. That's how to open an angle. Go pick up the ball. What you'd say is back on your point with Wang and how he started this final is we saw that hot shot moment, if you like, from Fan Zhendong. It's got to be that good. You've got to find that area of the table, that sort of shape, torque, to be able to win a point right now.
I mean, you see this, Fan Zhendong almost getting desperate here of what he feels like he has to do. But Wang Chuqin isn't exactly a short player, on the taller side of a Chinese player, but yet he can still recover so fast. Playing it into his middle doesn't seem as effective as what it would do against other players of his height. That was a poor touch for his standards, but usually as well, his in and out footwork gets overlooked because of his speed at the back of the table. He barely even ever lobs. If he's out of position, he's going to just do a fish low. He's not going to give you basically any time, and we saw that especially with Dang Chou.
No. Utterly dismissive of that as well. I mean, remember here, the top two in the world, you've got the world number one, the double world champion, who is really here right now, struggling for a consistent answer in the face of this level from Wang. Just pops up a little again there, in time in recent moments, but still a lead of five.
Nice fade there from Fan. I think he earned his own fortune. Favoured the brave. Unequivocal there, Wang. Snappy play there from Fan. Look at the base, how stable it is. Wide, got that low centre of gravity and the still head just to get the control. Wherever he is, whatever shot he plays. Interesting.
Led 9-3, Wang in this second game.
Kind of like in this alpha mentality right now. I shall not call the timeout. Not yet.
Thinking about it now, you're absolutely spot on, Fraser, because he's lost 5 points in a row.
This is exceptional from Fan. He has almost perfectly gauged the percentages of how he needs to play here. And most crucially, he has indeed stayed ice cool.
Now has the service here. And now that push back in at him from Wang at that moment. The mentality of these two. Incredible.
The ability to forget the scoreboard. I mean, you'd have to imagine this would be deflating for Fan coming all the way back for nothing.
Indeed, that is the case, and Wang pumps the fist, knew the importance of that. They resume, and we are all enthralled with it. Continue to be. Wang Chuqin now two up on Fan Zhendong, but you just get the sense there is so much more still to come here. I think at their previous meetings as well, it backs up that suggestion. And also the fact as well, as we reflect back on that previous game, you look at it, he's two up. He's won that second 11-9. He's won that point with aplomb. 9-3. Fun even in a losing cause. You can gain something from that, perhaps. And anything for you that those recent passages of play, anything standing out there in how they were won and lost?
I think he was just recovering the parallel balls that Wang gave him a little bit better, because Wang's always trying to get down that line. But apart from that, tough to say. Just look at it. I mean, it's just jaw-dropping how regularly he finds it, how he can tighten a screw that already seems like any more it's going to snap the wood.
Delivers there, but Fun, the previous point is he saw it go past him, not for the first time. Just kind of an acceptance. They both know each other so well and what the other can do. They've both been on the receiving end of it in that head-to-head. And Wang Chuqin, who's talked about that focus that he's needed through the week, will know that he needs to stay right there, how he's been so far. Any slight slip in focus, likely to be punished. Eyes on the prize, both of them.
You really get the sense with Wang Chuqin that he's his own worst critic, but from others, he shall demand respect. Change the serves up as well. Bit of fortune. Returned. Serves back with Fan Zhendong. Be interested to see a bit more reverse pendulum action of Fan. Maybe into the middle. Maybe test the waters as well into the wide forehand with that. The Zhong Jike Mark II reverse pendulum. Not a serve Wang does. Usually just the pendulum and the shovel with him.
That's juicy point construction there. Yeah.
Much better maneuverability. Wider serve, more intentful push. And then didn't need a powerful stroke for the winner.
Yeah, because he worked the space.
Exactly.
To play into. Fine point.
I think the Chinese take such good accountability of the passage of play. They'll be saying to themselves, OK, why am I having to play powerful shots? They think along those lines.
Yeah, he didn't miss out by too much there, and he knows it. They go into the latest towel break here, locked level in game three.
What I love about the touch there is that there's more body work than there is in the hand. The hand is just there. But the body's doing all the work, adjustments, the shuffle, in and out footwork. And it's so still, the hand. It's literally a touch. It's that juxtaposition between that and then the out and out fire play. Firebrand Chinese table tennis. I'll elaborate on a point that I previously made, because of course, playing power is what these guys want to do as early as possible. But if the other player is just there blocking, you know you're being controlled.
subtle change of direction, length, enough for fun.
It's like a frisbee, isn't it? The way he sends that out, it's just, oh, brilliant, absolutely brilliant.
Misses cross table again there. Missed over the table before. Again, gestures, fun. Over it a little bit more there.
Was a cheeky, emphatic shot. Oh. Look at the exaggerated movement, how horizontal the bat has to be.
Wang, though, with the service, back with the service here. Two serves to come to go and take a three-game lead, he'll hope. That's the first part of the job done. Really trying to come round and flick receive there. Fun. First time in this game he's failed to execute.
Every right-hander struggles to trap the spin with the forehand or even do a guide flick against that.
Game point one. Oh! Pushes through. It's an edge ball to save the game point. Oh, living on the edge here. Fun. So close to being three down. Could that be a turning point, pivotal moment to reference in this final? I mean, we're talking millimetres from being three down in a best of seven.
I mean, that could be a kind of Truls Morrigard versus Francisco moment in Houston. An edge to keep the dream alive. Oh, my.
Yeah, the tables can turn. A heartbeat here. Fun with game point now.
What a way to defuse any wavering thought. The unwavering Guang Chuqin. That was not an easy ball to play like that at all. A Fan Zhendong fan there or Guang Chuqin? It was tough to tell.
Just a fan of the sport. Misses this time. Everyone here and around the world just enjoying what these two are bringing on the biggest stage. And goes, and another towel break. It's a fourth this particular game.
Just contacting it in the wrong area there, Fan. Couldn't get behind it quick enough and came up the back of the ball. Didn't fully warrant it. Ooh! Escapes that one as well, Wang.
Second game point now here for Wang. Well, a start to match what he's produced here, and Fan Zhendong is in deep trouble in this championship match in Doha. Guang Chuqin, the defending champion, with a razor-sharp opening to game four that if he takes it, defend his title. Well, he might be three down, but he's arguably there, produced the best shot of the contest so far.
that was gorgeous from Fan Jendong. A backspin hook. He's come right under and around the side of that. Brilliant feeling from Fan Jendong. And then again, a shot with basically no backspin and loads of wrist. He's pulling out a few tricks here, maybe, just to try and get into the head of Wang Qiuquan. Try and distract him, maybe?
Well, he hasn't got into the head of Dato so far here. Try as he might. Oh, swats that away. There's a bit of anger, venom, frustration in Fan. What about this for a series of points from a man who's three down in the final? I think he was three up. No, I was going to say, in terms of their head-to-head between the two, this is the 13th meeting. Fourth final meeting in a row. But you go back over their meetings since 2019, and there's only been one drubbing in the sense of one time where one of them has failed to win a game. Anyways, the most unlikely, I'd suggest, if you were predicting. If you were going to predict the outcome, and I never asked you that, Fraser, you never asked me, because in these contests, I mean, it's a thankless task trying to predict what will happen on the day. It's just a case of who's the best on the day. But that would be an... I would have backed away from that, a 4-0 in this case.
Yeah, if you betted on Wang to win the first three games, happy retirement.
Fan finds 5 points, that is, in this fourth game. That he simply has to win to keep this final going in Doha.
Yeah. Kind of more statured, creative player Fan might have worked initially, but now that surprise factor isn't so surprising anymore. He's going to have to go back to the active play. A lot of people have said, you know, about Charles Morgard, why doesn't he try and use more flair against Wang Qiuquan? Obviously, he's never beaten Wang Qiuquan before, the former vice world champion, but you just don't get the time. You do need a bit of time to use feeling, and you basically don't really get that with Wang. Constricts you with that pace, constant pace against basically any shot. I mean, there, you can just see his speed. He played a backhand flick from the forehand territory and then still plays the backhand from the backhand. How quick he comes in and out. Finally trying it all here.
Yeah. Problem is, nothing's working for him consistently for any sort of consistent length of time. Wang, yeah, chopping away there. But it's again the measure of this man, and what he can do and how difficult he is to stop in this mood.
And we're getting a side out of Fan Jendong that you basically never get to see.
He's running out of time here. Here have been utterly enthralled in this. So they might be, and they're still on the edge of their seats. You still know with Fan Jendong, anything is possible. This is a position I'm sure he'd be the first to admit he finds troubling. He just doesn't get a look in there.
I mean, Ma Long's tried to do this, just try and slow it down a bit. See if he freezes, but he just doesn't freeze. A seatbelt shot there on the lean. Still pings it down the shorter length. Desperate times, desperate measures.
Two serves here to take it all. You wouldn't be surprised if he does so. He's been the definition of ice-cool composure, of clinical conviction, of everything. Wang Chuqin, 3 championship points. It's back-to-back WTT finals titles for Wang Chuqin. He saves his very...